council will come to order. It's a meeting of the City Council of Newburgh for September 8th, 2014, beginning at 7 p.m. We will begin our meeting by prayer from Pastor Joel Sheets from the Grace Community Church, after which we will say the Pledge of Allegiance. Go ahead.
We pray, Father in heaven, bless us as we gather today for this meeting. Guide our minds and hearts so that we will work for the good of our community and help all your people. Teach us to be generous in our outlook, courageous in the face of difficulty, and wise in our decisions. We seek blessings on the tasks before the city. Bless all efforts with clear insight, deliberations with wisdom, work with clarity and accuracy, and decisions with impartiality. The council gathers to make decisions for our community. May the council use only their best skills and judgment, keeping themselves impartial and neutral as they consider the merits and the pitfalls of each matter that is placed before them, and always act in accordance with what is best for our community and our fellow citizens. Father, we praise you, for you are God forever and ever. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Roll call.
Councilwoman Abram.
Here.
Councilwoman Angelo.
Here.
Councilman Brown. Councilwoman Holmes.
Here.
Councilwoman Lee.
Here.
Councilwoman Mejia.
Here.
Mayor Kennedy.
Here. Okay. We have some communications, and there's after the minutes, I need a motion for the approval of the minutes of the meeting of August 11th, 2014. May I have a motion? Second? Here's a move already here by Councilwoman. And this is a second. All in our roll call.
Councilwoman Abrams.
Aye.
Councilwoman Angelo.
Here.
Yes.
Councilman Brown.
Yes.
Councilwoman Holmes.
Yes.
Councilwoman Lee.
Yes.
Councilwoman Mejia.
Yes.
Mayor Kennedy.
Yes.
Naomi, would you get some agendas, please?
Sure. There's a couple of other communications that I would like to do for a minute, and that is one I would like to stand this week is the commemoration of 9/11. And so if we could all just stand for a moment and hold all the people that were part of that in memory. This week will be a hard week for many, and we want to remember the service that so many have given and the lives that were taken out that fateful day. I also want to remind everybody, tomorrow is primary day, so be sure and vote. And I want to remind everybody about a police open house that we have on September 20th. On Saturday at 401 Washington Street at the Activity Center. And they will be also passing out applications for the exam. This is again Saturday, September 20th. We're especially encouraging all city residents to please apply. And we're really focusing right now on getting a diversity of applicants to apply, and increasing the diversity on our workforce, women and minorities, and so encourage that from our city residents. And the last, I think that's the last thing that just specifically needed to be communicated right at the minute, okay? So now we'll move into presentations, and at this point what we'd like to do, let's see, while I bring up all of the auxiliary officers, if they could come forward.
We could hear the chief.
Mm-hmm.
And Chief Ferrara, could the auxiliary officers please all come right here to the front?
I want to move that chair.
Let's see. We have two new officers being sworn in, and if we could have our clerk to come forward. I'm trying to do things from the backwards here.
Yeah, I could get that.
Okay.
The agenda?
She's bringing it up.
Okay. Chief Ferrara, where are you going here? You would present to the
Thank you.
If the City Council would like to all stand. I don't know how we're going to get everybody in, but we're going to work on it. Maybe three of you go to that end and three come around to this end.
Hey, let's go. We'll do this end.
How you doing?
Right, how are you doing?
Get out there.
Okay. That's nice. Before I give these certificates, I'd like to say that I'm very proud of the Auxiliary Police and all that they've done over the years. They have contributed countless hours at concerts and community events and parades and year around, and they volunteer their time, and they show up in uniform, and they've done a lot of work for the city of Newburgh, and it's really it's an unbelievable amount of work that they've done. And I know the Auxiliary Police in Newburgh has been in effect since 1969, I believe, 1970. And Russ, thank you. I want to really especially appreciate your service and your decades of service here. It means a lot. Thank you for keeping it all together. Very proud. My first certificate is Augustine Calamano. Clarence Colomaris. Might as well take this one too. Jesse Howard. Captain Bevere. There we go. Cindy Calamano. Our newest officer. Thank you, Cindy. John Sheridan. And Desiree Rodriguez. Jesse.
Yes, we have three new candidates to become auxiliary police. We have on the left here, we have Leandra, we have Pedro, and we have Ardeer. Yes.
Naomi's coming with them all.
That's what.
I had the extra one.
Oh, okay. She must be making. I had another one. All right. Then the next thing. Let's see.
It's on the drop box.
Now I would like, we got lots of presentations. I'd like to call forth Elizabeth McKean. Where is she?
Here.
Right there.
Betsy.
All right.
Betsy.
Betsy.
Oh, God.
I'm forgetting something.
1977.
Lots of pieces going on here. All right, come over here. There we go. We're going to get our act together here yet.
Okay.
So, we want to present to Betsy McKean. Actually, Elizabeth, but more fondly known as Betsy around here, certificate of recognition for being the City of Newburgh records management officer and oh so much more. She's worked at Washington Headquarters State Historic Site in 2009, Woman of History.
Yeah.
Co-chair of Newburgh Beacon Bay Hudson Fulton Champlain Quadricentennial Committee.
You did very well.
I get that all out.
Yeah.
Active participant in the Quesate Creek Estuary Preserve and Mill Trail Planning. Longtime champion for stabilization and adaptive reuse of the Dutch Reformed Church. By the way, some folks were looking at that today to figure out something else. Creative interpretive materials for the Old Town Cemetery, the Dutch Reformed Church, Quesate Creek Estuary Preserve. Co-published the Experience Newburgh Tourism Brochure and installed and maintained the Waterfront Tourism Kiosk. It is with sincere appreciation for all you've done to preserve, protect, and promote the history and the resources of the City of Newburgh. We really wish you, she's talking about this retirement thing, you know? that's what the conversation is going on.
I've been talking about it for 10 years, all of you have heard this.
And we are going to really miss you, and I know you're going to, we're working through how to make that transition.
We're working on transition.
But the big...
You know I'll never be far.
Never far. And the real thing here is she has put a lot of effort into preserving and making sure that the records of this city are safe. We've moved them so many times, I don't even know how many times, and every move, she stands over them like they're her babies. Make sure that those things are going to be safe and be taken care of. So my congratulations to you.
Thank you so much.
And thank you so much, and let's take a little picture of the yard.
certificate.
I know that you don't usually say something after this, but I first came to this building in 1977, and I've got to say that there's never been a morning that I haven't woken up and said to myself, I've got to get to Newburgh. So it's been a long haul. It's been so worth it. And I've been so lucky to work with an extraordinary community and just a superlative set of collection records. I've been very lucky. Just want you all to know that. Thank you.
Thanks, Betsy.
Well, it's very tall.
So we have another person who is getting ready to retire, and that is Ann Kuzmic, who's been a faithful administrative assistant to the city manager and also much more as well. She's been the coordination of special events and spent a lot of time with our deputy mayor, Regina Angelo, with international festivals and sales down at the waterfront and fireworks and Memorial Day parades and river walks and art walks and all kinds of things. She has managed the permitting process for the city for quite a while. And the coordination of our press conferences and press releases and getting communication out about the city. And has actually served as secretary to two charter review commissions. It is with sincere appreciation for all you've done to preserve, protect, and promote everything that goes on here in the city and to really work with our management team. Thank you oh so much. Out of the way here for just a minute.
Because Betsy had to talk. I just want to say it's been an honor and a pleasure to work with all the councils and mayors and managers over the years, and most importantly, to serve the people of the city of Newburgh. So I can't say anything else. Thank you.
Let me see if I can sort this through here. And the next thing, I want to make sure we talk about the Hispanic Heritage Proclamation. And is there somebody here from the
Latinos Unidos for that group that I can give this to? Yes?
Yep.
All right. If you could come forward. And you want to bring everybody? Bring them all. So today I want to read a proclamation, The Hispanics, a Legacy of History, a Present of Action, and a Future of Success, in recognition of the National Hispanic Heritage Month, September 15th to October 15th, 2014. During this month, the nation celebrates Hispanic culture, achievements, heritage, and commemorates the following historical events which occur during this time period. The anniversary of independence of Costa Rica, El Salvador, Guatemala, Honduras, Nicaragua, Mexico, Chile, and Belize, and Columbus Day, October 12th. In the city of Newburgh, the Hispanic community makes up nearly 48% of the population, and their traditions and rich culture are reflected in the wonderful diversity of our community. Therefore, I, Judith L. Kennedy, Mayor of the City of Newburgh, New York, proclaim September 15th to October 15th as Hispanic Heritage Month in the City of Newburgh. To help you all to do that celebrating and to enjoy the rich culture of the Hispanic community, there is R&M Productions, that's Eddie Ramirez, will be holding a Hispanic Heritage Festival on Sunday, September 14th from 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. at the Ralph Rizzio property down by the ferry parking lot. So that's September 14th, 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. down at the ferry parking lot. So join in that. And then the other one is the Festival Independencia de Mexico 2014. That's Saturday, September 13th. That's this coming weekend. From 1 to 8 p.m., and that's at Delano Hitch Recreation Park at 401 Washington Street, Newburgh, New York. So I'd encourage everybody to go attend and celebrate this great opportunity. And is there anything you'd like to add to that?
Gracias, and please come and join us. Food. There's a lot of food.
The best thing to celebrate, Domino's. Right?
Yeah.
All right, thank you. Well, that's a lot of celebrating. I love it when we've got good news and great things going on in the city. It's a good thing. We're going to move now. I see there's something here in the agenda, the comptroller's report, that's actually on the second Monday or the second meeting of the month, so that isn't actually going to happen tonight. It's on the wrong schedule. So then we'll turn to the city manager's report. Mr. Caravino, do you want to give us your report?
Comments from the comments.
Oh, excuse me. Yeah, we'll do
comments.
Got to go down that road. Comments from the public right now concerning agenda items. Remember, you speak your name, your location, and then the agenda item that you're referring to so that we know which item you're talking about. Please keep your time to 3 minutes.
okay?
Oh, we got it.
Good. Oh, here, you'll notice this is the 3-minute timer we're trying out, so you can see what when your time's almost up, okay? All right, go ahead.
Good evening. My name is Sandra Kassam, and I'm a resident in the town of Newburgh. And I'm here this evening because I'm very pleased to see that comments that I made the last time I arrived and was here regarding the oil trains that are rolling down along the river was obviously became a topic of discussion. I see on this tonight's agenda that you are going to be voting on a resolution to oppose this activity and to encourage the safety, the adoption of safety regulations, because this is a very clear and present danger. I will add one thing. I went to a meeting last night at the rowing club, and there was a speaker there from the riverkeeper, and he made one comment that I think bears sharing with your body, and that is he said that the Bakken crude, which is being transported by these long tanker cars, is as explosive as gasoline. But that really stuck in the mind. I just want to share that with you, among other things, as explosive as gasoline. But nevertheless, I applaud your resolution that you're going to be acting on this evening, and I trust all of you will approve it. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Sandra.
Thank you.
Hi, my name's Richard Harper. I'm a resident at 110 Du Bois Street, and I'm also chairman of the Conservation Advisory Council.
Can you speak up or speak into the...
Trying to.
If I need to, you can raise that if you need to.
I think you... Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
Okay. As chairman of the council, I just wanted to speak in support of and congratulate you for resolution 25. That has to do with the crude oil transport. We've been discussing that at great length in the Conservation Advisory Council meetings, and it was unanimous among our members that we would send a memo to the council and the mayor and the city manager encouraging just what you've already done. So we appreciate what you're doing, and we're in full support. Thanks.
Thank you.
My name is Lily Norton. I'm also speaking about the issue of the crude oil, and it's extremely dangerous. The cars that they're using, there are safer cars that they can use, but they don't have enough now to transport it. And I think we have to do everything to keep the residents of the city of Newburgh safe. There have been places where they've had accidents and where many people have been killed. And they are unable to put out the fire with the normal means. And I don't know what protection our fire department would have if anything should happen in the city of Newburgh down at the waterfront. So I think it's extremely important that we protect our citizens and vote for this.
Thank you, Lily.
Thank you.
Peace, family. How y'all doing?
Good. Do you want to raise
Thomas
it?
My name is Thomas Breeland.
Do you want to raise it up, or take the mic in your hand, whichever.
I got a big mouth. I could be heard. But my name is Thomas Breeland. I'm a resident of the city of Newburgh, located on 206 Liberty Street. And what I'm going to speak about, I see that y'all have here with the demolition project with Downing Park and everything. And I'd like to know, is it possible that we could also get the help with Audrey Carey Park that's located on Liberty Street and everything, because they too has an abandoned building there where it puts the children in danger and everything. We'd be having family day events out there, and it seems like, you know, The children are sneaking inside that abandoned building. They got wires hanging around that building and everything, all right? I seen a few of the children in the last Children's Day event. They were swinging on the wires that's hanging.
That door, there's an opening. They can get in there?
It was a hole there. I see that they did close it now because the children were sneaking into the hole and everything, going, trying to get into that building to play around in the building and everything. That's very dangerous.
Okay.
And I have a suggestion that why not just take that building down and open it up more with more playgrounds, new mats and everything, because they're ripping the mats up and all. I have pictures of how the park needs to get renovated itself also. If it could go out to Downing Park, why not bring it in the city and renovate, help fix up this park? Because if you want the truth, that's the only park that I've seen so far that where the children do have to play at. That's the only part. You got to remember the babies. And just remember, we all in here was babies. And we all at least had some place to have to play and enjoy ourselves. And let's not forget the children. All right? And I also, yes, I do have a petition here of the people who, of over 200 names, that agree that they would like that park to be renovated. I have it here in pictures, if y'all like. I'll pass it to the city council.
Yeah, you can give it to us right here.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you, Thomas.
All right? Because my current concern is the future, and that's the danger.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
My name is Bhajan Singh. I'm here for Lake Street Bridge. My resident address is 6 Hope Court, Newburgh, New York. And I have a business of 115 Lake Street, Sunoco Gas Station. With the closure of the road, I lost about 35% of the business. And I pay close to $50,000 in taxes. So please think to rebuild that bridge as soon as possible. Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Borden Powers. I'm a proud citizen and resident of Newburgh, New York. And I'm here about the Lake Street Bridge. We're going into our fourth month of that bridge having been closed. And I've had the privilege, in addition to meeting with Mr. Singh, meeting with a number of other business people who are being severely impacted by the closure of that bridge. I know there isn't anybody at this table. By the way, thank you so much for what you do. There isn't anybody at this table who isn't in a hurry to get that bridge fixed. I know that, so we're all pulling in the same direction. But I just want you to know that there wasn't a businessman I talked to in the course of this survey that I did that wasn't hurting seriously because that bridge has been closed. There was one man, have to remain nameless, who had to close down a restaurant because of it. And another man I talked with who said that if this bridge doesn't get repaired by sometime in the first quarter of next year, that he's going to have to close his business down. So this is a very, very serious situation. I know that there's a procedure that has to be followed, and I can't recommend you change the procedure. And I know that the odds are pretty good that if we follow on the procedure we have now, that it won't be until sometime in December until we can identify who the contractor is going to be to do the work. And then, of course, we're faced with the winter months. We need to find a way, obviously not out of city bucks, to find a way somehow to support those folks who are in there. If it's doing something that introduces people from other parts of the city to at least go down there and get their nails fixed or get a meal or whatever, but we need to support those people somehow. And I don't have the answer to that, but I urge you to consider that. I also know full well that if we are to finish this assignment at a time which saves these businesses, then we're going to have to rely upon a strength far greater than our own. And that's the strength of our Lord. Because if we follow the procedure that we have, it's going to take us X number of months here and X number of months there. I think it's time, very frankly, to call upon our Lord in such a way as not only as a team, but as a community. I also think it's terribly important for us to be known as the city that is very friendly to the business community. a solution, we need to be the community that is heroic to the businesses, because I can't think of anybody who is more important in this city than any people in the city than the business owners of this city. They supply not only the goods and the services and much of the revenue, but they also supply the jobs. And we've got to find a way to support them, because everything will flow from that. Now, back to our Lord for just a minute. I have a verse. Time is up.
Your time has up.
There's a really good prayer that I'm going to recommend, and I'm going to ask you to say it with me. It goes like this. Help God! You ready? One, two, three. Help God! And Newburgh said, amen.
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 All right. Watch the timer.
We'll work on that. My name is Charles Thompson. I'm here representing Heights Lumber Center, and unfortunately, we're due south of the bridge. We've been closed for too many months, and I can't begin to ask for the city's help, because we've dealt with recessions. We've dealt with big boxes coming into our community. We've dealt with the worst winter we had in 40 years, and we just got through that, and things start to pick up, and all of a sudden, bang, the bridge is closed. I have contractors not coming in because it's too much of a hassle to get to Heights, so they might go somewhere else. I have somebody saying, oh, I thought you were closed. You know, I said, we've been open for 40 years. The bridge is going to close us, not for a while. And I have people coming from, you know, other counties, and they just turn around and go back because they have no, you know, they can't, even use the GPS, they can't, you know. So it's imperative that, you know, we act in a way to get this bridge fixed as quick as possible, because it's affecting so many businesses on Lake Street, and you have no idea what a negative way, it needs to be dealt with as quickly as anybody here can get it dealt with. Thank you.
Thanks.
Thanks. Okay. Council input on agenda items.
I'm going to say something about that Lake Street.
Okay.
I went down there today and I spoke to some of the people. The businesses are really suffering down there, and I did mention to someone we should have a huge sign up saying our businesses are open, and those barrels are right to the entrance to where the businesses are. That's the problem. People think they can't go over that way, and they just don't go in there. I don't know what else we could do right now, but we are going to vote on something tonight, taking this into consideration for an engineering company to come in to start working maybe on that, give us some idea what to do. Like we don't feel bad, we really.
Yeah, we in fact, we feel terrible about it. So I know that the city manager and I went down to that street on Friday, I believe it was, or Thursday. And one notion is our DPW here tonight? Is George here?
No.
If we could ask George to move the barricades that are on the right-hand side going south so that people can go all the way down, and then the suggestion by Councilman Brown last Thursday night was to put up, got that right, Jersey barriers?
Jersey walls.
Jersey barriers across the bridge, because people are actually moving them and driving across them. Please understand the situation there is that the culvert itself is collapsing. So I would also like to ask our engineer, our city engineer, Jason, is there a possibility that we could work with the design company that's doing the designs? They've said a month and a half. I would like the design company to understand how much is at stake for how many businesses. I think there's 30 or 40 businesses along on both sides of the bridge that are really struggling. What would it take for that design company to get this done in double time?
Good evening, Mayor. I spoke with the design company after the council meeting on Thursday night, and I expressed the need to get this open as soon as possible, and they actually began work on that Friday.
Okay.
So they began to expedite the design and to schedule the surveyor.
And then what we want to be able to do, and even if we have to call a special meeting, whatever it takes, the minute that design guideline is done and we can put that to bed, whatever it takes so we can get, because I know there's a certain time frame for everything to be. So in every way that we can expedite, I want these businesses to know that we will expedite this, because I know this is a very serious issue. And my heart goes out, because your lifeblood is on the line, and I do understand that, and I think every member of this council understands that. We are doing everything we know to make this right.
I'm sorry, Jace, I've never been in a situation where there wasn't a temporary fix to a permanent problem, and I've asked you on a number of occasions if there's a possible temporary fix to this permanent problem, mm-hmm. to allow traffic to cross that bridge until we can get it fixed permanently. Mm-hmm. When do you think you might be able to know that information, that if...
Based on the council meeting on Thursday, I contacted a temporary bridge company that can come in and do temporary bridges, and I'm waiting for quotes on that.
Okay. Yeah, because stretching this out into the next year will right. severely damage the... It's already damaging the economy. Over
yeah, I expect to have an answer this week on a temporary bridge situation.
Okay.
Even if it's a one-way bridge, or we, you know, people could go across back
yeah,
and
I'll
forth?
Yeah, I'll get some prices to see what our options are there.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
In terms of rental.
I know that Jason and I had the conversation about the steel plates.
Right. Mm-hmm.
But it's the whole culvert. I thought it was just the sewer. So it's a 32-foot span?
It would be a larger span to span beyond the abutment. So about a 40-45-foot span for a temporary bridge. So they're working on a price for that, and I'll have something to you this week for okay. a temporary bridge.
Okay.
Jason, I know I went through a few times to the high-rise Lake Street. Mm-hmm. You tour all that. You just come right out, and you don't even hit any of that.
Yeah, I've done that too.
If anyone wanted to take that route instead of having to go all the way down to 9W.
The Lake Drive route?
Yeah, come right out there. You're not interfering.
We have to remember
the
that route is limited to 3 tons, so trucks can't go through that road. It can't be a truck route.
Otherwise,
cars can, but trucks cannot.
Right.
It's a weight limit. So, to your another suggestion, Councilwoman Angelo, and City Manager, you and I talked about it as well. Two things we can do to help. One is move those barriers going south, so and have the local sign just in the middle, so people can at least get up and down and into the little strip mall there. And also get to the health center, because that's an issue there. And then the second thing we could possibly do, if we could get the names of the businesses that are hurting, and maybe we could post those right at Broadway and Lake Street, Route 32.
Doing advertising.
And you're okay, Elizabeth, have you talked about that? So we could put a sign up and encourage people to support the businesses during the bridge, while the bridge is down. And then what else did you suggest, Councilwoman?
We canvassed the area last week, and we're doing advertising in the Times Herald Record and also the Hudson Valley Press. So we're doing free advertising. Courtney Kane is the one taking care of that for the businesses, so people will know that you're open.
Okay, so everything we know how to do, we are trying to do that, and I want you to know that. Unfortunately, we cannot open the bridge because the sewer all the way across is the sewer is leaking, but the culvert itself that goes over the bridge is compromised, and it's too big of a risk to allow people to go over, because that whole thing could collapse. Okay, and any other comments on this subject?
Yes, the advertising and encouraging people to visit the little strip mall is great, and the advertising is great, but these things aren't going to really help Heights Lumber, which has been our city, one of our great businesses in our city for all these decades. And that nothing except, I think, the idea of having that temporary bridge put up will help Heights Lumber. So that's what I think, that's what I'm putting my great hopes in, that we will have that for you soon.
The big problem here, Jason, we don't have the cost yet. The bridge repair itself is close to $1 million. And that is all going to have to come out of funds that wasn't planned. So it's all we're moving things around, you know, from what is it called, borrowing from Peter to pay Paul. kinds of things. And this temporary bridge may be as much as the permanent fix. So we just don't know the answer to that question yet. And appreciate your looking into that. Okay? Say what?
That's right.
Yeah, we'll have to find a way to fund it, because at this moment we don't have it. Okay? All right. And got all that? So we'll turn the time now over to the city manager for the city manager's report.
Thank you, Mayor. First up is resolution number 216-2014, authorizing amendment of resolution number 114-2014 of April 28th, 2014, to authorize an extension of time to close title on the property located at 288 Grand Street, Section 10, Block 2, Lot 26, sold at private sale to Gregory Nato for the amount of $110,000, and authorizing the city manager to execute a pre-closing license agreement.
Okay. May I have a motion to pass resolution number 216-2014?
So moved.
A second?
I'll second it.
Roll call?
Councilwoman Abrams?
Aye.
Councilwoman Angelo?
Yes.
Councilman Brown?
Yes.
Councilwoman Holmes?
Yes.
Councilwoman Lee?
Yes.
Councilwoman Mejia?
Yes.
Mayor Kennedy?
Yes.
Resolution number 217-2014, approving the City of Newburgh's amended Community Development Block Grant Action Plan for fiscal year 2014 in the amount of $48,484.
May I have a motion to pass resolution number 217-2014?
I'll move it.
And a second?
Second.
Roll call?
Councilwoman Abrams?
Aye.
Councilwoman Angelo?
Yes.
Councilman Brown?
Yes.
Councilwoman Holmes?
Yes.
Councilwoman Lee?
Yes.
Councilwoman Mejia?
Yes.
Mayor Kennedy?
Yes.
Resolution number 218-2014, Newburgh Community Land Bank request for 151 Liberty Street to acquire along with adjoining property of 96 Broadway.
May I have a motion to pass resolution number 218-2014?
So move.
And a second?
I'll second it.
Roll call?
Councilwoman Abrams?
Aye.
Councilwoman Angelo?
Yes.
Councilman Brown?
Yes.
Councilwoman Holmes?
Yes.
Councilwoman Lee?
Yes.
Councilwoman Mejia?
Yes.
Mayor Kennedy?
Yes.
Resolution number 219-2014, authorizing the city manager to enter into an agreement with Swagit Productions, LLC, to provide services in connection with live streaming broadcasts of city council meetings and work sessions via the internet.
Motion to pass resolution number 219-2014. And a second?
Second.
Just a quick comment. Hallelujah. This is a good step forward to taking us to a place where people can watch our meetings live, right in session. So that's great. Okay. Roll call.
Councilwoman Abrams?
Aye.
Councilwoman Angelo?
Yes.
Councilman Brown?
Yes.
Councilwoman Holmes?
Yes.
Councilwoman Lee?
Yes.
Councilwoman Mejia?
Yes.
Mayor Kennedy?
Yes.
Resolution number 220-2014, authorizing the city manager to accept an Americans with Disability Act compliant swing from Unitex for use in a city park or playground.
May I have a motion to pass resolution number 220?
So move.
Second?
I'll second it. Can I just say something about a park?
Mm-hmm.
We have two parks at the moment, Hasbrook Park and Orange Carey Park, but we'll soon have Tyrone Crab Park, so maybe we should hold off, and that'll be a nice addition to Tyrone Crab Park.
We have to decide. So we do open it up for comments here. To the point of folks talking about parks, getting a swing, I've had a lot of people ask for swings, so we'll set that up so that could possibly go in Audrey Carey Park as a place for people to play. But more still, I was in that building that is open over there. That building actually could be fixed, but it absolutely needs to be secure, and the roof of that building in the back needs to be checked to see if it needs to be secured for the winter, because I think it's been leaking. And second of all, I think we really need to decide what we're going to do with that building, because the longer it sits, the worse it gets. And we just heard we've got children playing in that park, and they're getting into that thing.
Does the city own that building?
Yes, the city does. So we need to do something with that building. I agree. We just can't have kids breaking into that building and playing in that thing. That's really dangerous. Okay, let's see. Where are we? We need a roll call on this motion.
Councilwoman Abrams?
Aye.
Councilwoman Angelo?
Yes.
Councilman Brown?
Yes.
Councilwoman Holmes?
Yes.
Councilwoman Lee?
Yes.
Councilwoman Mejia?
Yes.
Mayor Kennedy?
Yes.
Resolution number 221-2014, authorizing the city manager to apply for and accept, if awarded, a grant in the amount of $25,000 from the New York State Department of Environmental Conservation under the 2013-2014 Urban and Community Forestry Grant, Round 12, award number T305-108.
May I have a motion to pass resolution number 221-2014?
So move.
Second?
I'll second.
Roll call?
Councilwoman Abrams?
Aye.
Councilwoman Angelo?
Yes.
Councilman Brown?
Yes.
Councilwoman Holmes?
Yes.
Councilwoman Lee?
Yes.
Councilwoman Mejia?
Yes.
Mayor Kennedy?
Yes.
Resolution number 222-2014, authorizing the city manager and the police chief to enter into a letter of agreement with the New York State Office of the Attorney General, memorializing the City of Newburgh Police Department's policies, procedures, and training protocols to ensure meaningful access to police services by individuals of limited English proficiency.
May I have a motion to pass resolution number 222-2014?
I'll move it.
And a second?
Second.
Roll call?
Councilwoman Abrams?
Aye.
Councilwoman Angelo?
Yes.
Councilman Brown?
Yes.
Councilwoman Holmes?
Yes.
Councilwoman Lee?
Yes.
Councilwoman Mejia?
Yes.
Mayor Kennedy?
Yes.
Resolution number 223-2014, authorizing the city manager to accept a proposal and execute an agreement with Quality Environmental Solutions and Technologies for asbestos abatement design services for the greenhouse demolition project at Downing Park at a cost of $5,800.
May I have a motion to pass resolution 223-2014?
I'll move it.
And a second?
Second.
Roll call?
Councilwoman Abrams?
Aye.
Councilwoman Angelo?
Yes.
Councilman Brown?
Yes.
Councilwoman Holmes?
Yes.
Councilwoman Lee?
Yes.
Councilwoman Mejia?
Yes.
Mayor Kennedy?
Yes.
Resolution number 224-2014, authorizing the city manager to accept a proposal and execute an agreement with Quality Environmental Solutions and Technologies for professional services related to sampling of suspected asbestos-containing material for the police department.
May I have a motion to pass resolution number 224-2014?
So move.
Yes. Second.
Roll call?
Councilwoman Abrams?
Aye.
Councilwoman Angelo?
Yes.
Councilman Brown?
Yes.
Councilwoman Holmes?
Yes.
Councilwoman Lee?
Yes.
Councilwoman Mejia?
Yes.
Mayor Kennedy?
Yes.
Resolution number 225-2014, authorizing the city manager to accept a proposal and execute an agreement with McLaren Engineering Group for inspection and design services related to repairing and rehabilitating the Route 32 Metal Arch Culvert Bridge, also known as the Lake Street Bridge, at a cost of $133,328.
May I have a motion to pass resolution number 225-2014?
So move.
A second?
I'll second it.
Roll call?
Councilwoman Abrams?
Aye.
Councilwoman Angelo?
Yes.
Councilman Brown?
Yes.
Councilwoman Holmes?
Yes.
Councilwoman Lee?
Yes.
Councilwoman Mejia?
Yes.
Mayor Kennedy?
Yes.
Resolution number 226-2014, authorizing the city manager to execute a license agreement with CSX Transportation, Inc. to allow the city and its contractors access to CSX property for the purpose of repairing the combined sewer overflow outfall number 12.
May I have a motion to pass resolution number 226-2014?
I'll move it.
Did I say resolution? And a second?
Second.
A roll call?
Councilwoman Abrams?
Aye.
Councilwoman Angelo?
Yes.
Councilman Brown?
Yes.
Councilwoman Holmes?
Yes.
Councilwoman Lee?
Yes.
Councilwoman Mejia?
Yes.
Mayor Kennedy?
Yes.
Resolution number 227-2014, amending resolution number 247-2013, the 2014 budget of the City of Newburgh, New York, to transfer $95,898 from special items contingency to sanitary sewer other services to provide necessary funding in connection with collapsed sewer lines.
May I have a motion to pass resolution number 227-2014?
So move.
A second?
I'll second it.
Roll call?
Councilwoman Abrams?
Aye.
Councilwoman Angelo?
Yes.
Councilman Brown?
Yes.
Councilwoman Holmes?
Yes.
Councilwoman Lee?
Yes.
Councilwoman Mejia?
Yes.
Mayor Kennedy?
Yes.
Resolution number 228-2014, authorizing the city manager to enter in an agreement for professional engineering design and construction services with Mazur Consulting in connection with the rehabilitation of the basketball courts located in the Delano Hitch Recreation Park.
Okay, we have a motion to pass resolution number 228-2014.
So move.
And a second?
I'll second it.
Roll call.
Councilwoman Abrams?
Aye.
Councilwoman Angelo?
Yes.
Councilman Brown?
Yes.
Councilwoman Holmes?
Yes.
Councilwoman Lee?
Yes.
Councilwoman Mejia?
Yes.
Mayor Kennedy?
Yes.
Resolution number 229-2014, supporting a four-year cyclical reassessment plan and authorizing the city manager and city assessor to apply for and accept if awarded aid for cyclical assessments from the New York State Department of Taxation and Finance Office of Real Property Tax Services.
May we have a motion to pass resolution number 229-2014?
I'll move it.
And a second?
Second.
Roll call.
Discussion.
Okay.
Is there a matching, any matching funds? Any, okay.
Okay. Roll call.
Councilwoman Abrams?
Aye.
Councilwoman Angelo?
Yes.
Councilman Brown?
Yes.
Councilwoman Holmes?
Yes.
Councilwoman Lee?
Yes.
Councilwoman Mejia?
Yes.
Mayor Kennedy?
Yes.
Resolution number 230-2014, to express concerns about transporting crude oil by rail, barge, and ship, and calling upon federal and New York state agencies to protect the public by enacting stringent rules and regulations for such transport, and to urge and encourage the exploration of alternative means for the transportation and distribution of crude oil.
May we have a motion to pass resolution number 230-2014?
So move.
And a second?
I'll second.
And roll call.
Councilwoman Abrams?
Aye.
Councilwoman Angelo?
Yes.
Councilman Brown?
Yes.
Councilwoman Holmes?
Yes.
Councilwoman Lee?
Yes.
Councilwoman Mejia?
Yes.
Mayor Kennedy?
Yes.
Resolution number 231-2014. Approving the consent judgment and authorizing the city manager to sign such consent judgment in connection with the tax certiorari proceedings against the city of Newburgh in the Orange County Supreme Court bearing Orange County Index Numbers 689-96-2011, 6226-2012, 5837-2013, and 5394-2014, involving Section 3, Block 11, Lot 1, of the Rove Real LLC.
May we have a motion to pass resolution number 231-2014? May I have a motion?
Cindy said she moves.
Second?
I'll second it.
Roll call.
Councilwoman Abrams?
Aye.
Councilwoman Angelo?
Yes.
Councilman Brown?
Yes.
Councilwoman Holmes?
Yes.
Councilwoman Lee?
Yes.
Councilwoman Mejia?
Yes.
Mayor Kennedy?
Yes.
Resolution number 232-2014, authorizing the settlement of litigation regarding the interim tax foreclosure of liens for the year 2012 relative to 92 DuPont Avenue, Section 26, Block 2, Lot 22.
May I have a motion to pass resolution number 232-2014?
So move.
And a second?
I'll second.
And roll call.
Councilwoman Abrams?
Aye.
Councilwoman Angelo?
Yes.
Councilman Brown?
Yes.
Councilwoman Holmes?
Yes.
Councilwoman Lee?
Yes.
Councilwoman Mejia?
Yes.
Mayor Kennedy?
Yes. Okay. Let's put that over there. Do we have any old business? Anything open on a table? Don't think so. Anything, any new business? Okay, having said that, then the public comment period regarding general matters of the city are open. And that, again, is, if you want to put the other timer up, please pay attention to the timer on the screen. Keep your comments to 3 minutes and state your name and your location and what your comment's about.
Drew Cardigan or 30 Meadow Street in the town of Newburgh, but also with a lot of properties in the city of Newburgh. I actually came to say goodbye to Ian McDougall, which I guess is leaving. I don't know if you all know that. He's been the Newburgh planner for about 9 years. He's done a pretty decent job. He brought an expertise to City Hall that did not have before he came. It's an expertise that Newburgh needs, be it from inside the city administration or from some via an outside qualified consultant. He's been here for 8 to 10 years. I understood his positions typically. I think you should all thank him for his service. He's done a pretty good job. I think we're going to miss him. I also bring up Ian's leaving for another reason, because as I understand it, he was supposed to be the one coordinating the new zoning ordinance, the rewrite. And Ian understands and understood the city far better than pretty much everybody else in the City Hall from a planning perspective. And I'll tell you, far, far better than the people who rewrote that or wrote the zoning ordinance that's under consideration now. You need expertise in the City Hall to do that. It's critically important that the rewrite be done from people working for city government. Right now, it's my understanding you still don't have a copy of the document in a form that you can use it, but you also don't have a copy of the contract under which I guess it's AKRF is working. And the concern I have with that is you don't know what they're supposed to produce, what they're supposed to give you, or quite literally who they're working for, unless you as a city are signing off on their work as being done or paying them. They're not working for you. I've learned that a long time ago. So you need a copy of the contract, but you also need a planner who knows what he's doing working for City Hall. It's not an expertise that somebody can make up as they go along. They need to know what they're doing. You need to figure out how you're going to do the rewrite. The other comment, which has nothing to do with what I was just talking about, is has anybody contacted the National Guard about getting a temporary bridge from them? Because that might work. Thank you.
Thanks.
Good ideas.
Good evening. My name is Arun Vora.
Could you pull it just a little closer? Thank you.
Okay. I would like to talk about the address 600 Broadway. It has a sign that the laundromat is coming soon. Needless to say that it's in the C3 zone. However, my laundromat and another very big laundromat exist within a 1 mile distance. Therefore, I do not believe that another laundromat is to be built at this time, because it's closer to me and I took over the business 2 years ago and I bought the building 2 months ago. And I was told to bring my concern here.
Where is your building?
488 Broadway.
488, and where's the other one?
600.
The other one is to be built, it has a sign that is coming soon on 600 Broadway.
Huh.
Close. Okay. Thank you.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Dolores Hamer. I'm here today because of this report that was put in the paper. For anyone who didn't see the report in the paper, and also the next day, an editorial was also done in the paper for 58 Johnson Street. I'm here because I feel like, for one, that's slander to my name, and you know I was the tenant living in there. All of that you said in there wasn't truth and wasn't facts. If you was gonna speak the truth, you should have spoke the truth. Not only that, on top of it, here's 20 violations that's dated back from 2013. Not only that, on top of it, I have the exterminator people who's also was coming there doing free extermination in that building on the strength that me and my kids was living there. Your building is also has lead in it, because I had a certified person check that as well. I mean, if a story was gonna be given, the story should have been given the right way. Them doors that you're holding up on the front door, these is doors that were sitting in the hot water room in the boiler room from the day I moved in there. Windows that was broken from the day I went in there. The building inspector came in and also asked where did the doors and everything else came from. The windows that was dropping, I have multiple friends whose fingers got caught in it. No one turned around, came and fixed anything in there. You're talking about beds that was all over the apartment. I have six kids. My mother stayed there with me. Me, my mother, and six kids. There was nothing left in there. When the sheriff come and evict you and put you out, there was nothing left on the property. Any garbage, or little items that was in there, your son asked me to leave in there and said he would clean it up. I was willing to get it all up. Not only that, how many different LLCs are you gonna keep switching to for this one property? Because we got a track record of all of that too. How many do you have listed with City Hall that you're in with? As you being the city mayor, why isn't any of this noted to the city public? But you coming up here putting me, a person out, on, trying to throw me out, like I went from your apartment, which your son gave me the address to the new apartment I currently live in, a 4-bedroom, 2 full finished bathrooms, and it's beautiful inside. So how can you say I'm a horrible tenant? I have several landlords call you when I made attempts to move out your apartment. Did you tell the paper that you gave every landlord a negative response for me, which made it harder for me to get an apartment? Which the apartment had to be put into my mother's name because no landlord would rent to me underneath my name because of the reference you left? Bearing, hard bearing, that's a hard bearing. I am a single mother with six kids. Yes, I do work, not one job, but two jobs in Woodbury Common. When I was living at your residence, I also held down a job. I had my child care provided there watching my child, which I have papers and statements on that.
Your time is up, and I'm going to,
This is ridiculous.
Your time is up.
Yeah, because we could go to zero from 100 real quick in here.
I'm going to, I'm going to claim the privilege of the chair right this minute because this needs to be addressed. There's been something laid out here. What was in the paper was exactly what is the situation. My son was in a situation where he and a person bought properties in this city under their LLC, whatever they did. That partner absconded with about $200,000 in the last 2 years, and my son discovered that. So what happened out of that is that I stepped in as a mother about last September and discovered the situation in these properties. During last fall, I put in a new water heater when that went down. I fixed a furnace. I got extermination there when she told me she had problems with that. I had a contractor come in January and evaluate all of the violations and codes. The code violations came with the property. It was already under code violation. And what you need to know is that the contractor told me that with as many children, and the beds were gone. She's right, the beds were gone when they moved. The beds were all on the floor, and that there was so many children and furniture and things in the way that they could not safely do any kind of repairs with that much going on in the apartment. I sent a letter on January 17th asking her to move because I needed to go in and fix the code violations. I have a copy of that letter here.
Excuse me.
Sit down.
Excuse me.
Sit down.
I'm sorry. Excuse me. Please, Mayor Kennedy, don't make this the place that you use
somebody
to explain
else
the code
done.
Violations. No, no, we're not going to do this. We are not going to do this.
I have already.
No, this is not going to be the place that you use to explain your code violations.
Oh, yes, it is.
I'm asking you to stop. Well, I'm asking you to stop.
I have,
you have
claimed
done
the privilege
nothing
of the chair, and
you
I'm
cannot
sorry
use
you set this
your
up
chair to
yes,
discuss
I
your
am
personal business.
Somebody brought their personal business here.
This is your personal business, and I want it out of this city council meeting. It's not fair to us. It is not fair to the people who come here, and we are trying to conduct business. You made a mistake. Own your mistake and move on. Yes. You had no right doing that.
It's okay for councilmen.
Let's continue with comments from the public so that we can all go home.
We will not. We will not.
No. No, Mayor
Kennedy. We will not.
Then I will continue to interrupt you because this is just fine.
Actually, I can have you dismissed from the meeting for this. I looked up Robert's rules.
And I can assure you, if you have me dismissed, You'll be doing it because anybody else would rather eat their tongue. Now you try it.
Oh,
you try it.
So
yeah, that's
in that
what
case,
I thought.
Well, in that case,
that's what I thought. Comments from the public,
and,
Mayor Kennedy.
And as the chair of this meeting, I have the right to claim conversation. And if somebody's going to publicly attack me on a personal issue, this is not a politics. You are publicly bringing this to the table. No, somebody else called it, not me. I never called the paper. Oh, that's right. So this was a setup on me, and now the person who does the setup wants to not have any comment. So let's just get clear here. This is a political situation, and it's a setup for me. And if you read the paper, what I said was true.
That's all.
Okay.
Mayor.
And that's what I'm trying to do. You wouldn't move. You're the one who wouldn't move.
This is not productive anymore.
So this conversation, if you want to talk about comments of the city, we'll go from there. We'll go from there if you want to talk about comments from the city.
She's the chair. She has to tell us.
Yes. I'm here for a follow-up on my discussion dealing with Audrey Carey Park.
Yes, that's good.
Because that's very, to me, it may not be important to y'all, but it's important to the community, and especially for the children.
Did you hear a comment a minute ago, or did you step out at that moment?
Well, I didn't hear the comment. This is why I'm coming up here. If I heard it, I wouldn't be up here now.
Okay. Right. So we said we were going to, first of all, make absolutely certain that that building was secure, because I agree with you, it is unsafe, and we need to do something with that building. I agree with you, sir, wholeheartedly. Okay. Wholeheartedly. And I think this council wants to make sure our children are safe.
Because that's the main question is when. When it will be done.
Yes, I agree.
You know, because we don't have really, as they would say, time is of essence. As long as you're sitting back debating and everything else, nothing is getting done. Because we got to get things done. You want a better city? Well, then do your duty and put it into effect.
And by the way, you do know that we're working on a third park over at
I know that.
Park,
you're working on that park. Work on the park where the children can play in now. Right. That's the park that you got to work on. Because everyone at least know where their babies are. They won't have to be worrying about what's going on. At least then they know where their children are at. That's the main fact. All right? Let's start getting this community in order. And that's what got to be done. That is your duty. That is your duty. Let's get it into motion.
Thank you.
So please let us know when this is going to take effect.
We can't tell you we're going to tear down a building. Please know that. But I'm not saying that. We are going to make sure the building is safe.
Well, renovate it to at least have a bathroom where therefore then activities could be stored at in the building for the park.
That would be a great idea.
Not just standing there like a loaf of bread wondering what's going on with it. Do something with the park, with that building then. This is why you have a park department. That could be a park department station where at least it could be some things could be put up there and put into motion for the park.
Okay.
Think of the babies. Like I said, think of the babies. All right? Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Yeah, I heard you. Omari Shakur, Universal God. Yeah, I came here to talk about the land right behind the park right here on Broadway between Johnson and Nander Street.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, because the security guard and Department of Motor Vehicle, he stops me every day I walk by there. He asks, what can we do about all that brush and stuff back there? Because there's a lot of kids be playing back there, and we don't want no kid to get snatched up, because it's like a jungle there. It's a jungle within the jungle. And we just want to know who has to clean that up. Is the city responsible?
Are you talking about the one on Johnson Street?
We're talking about the park right here on Broadway, Johnson and Lander Street, across from Social Services. Behind it, all them bushes, and looks like a jungle habitat right there.
So, you know that we trimmed all the...
I know you're not from Newburgh, so you don't know what we're talking about. But anyway, what we're talking about, we're talking about the piece of property that's right between Johnson and Lander, behind the park on Johnson Street. I think that's a park. There's no benches or nothing there. There's no benches or nothing there. I don't know why they say it's a park, because you can't, you gotta stand and watch the trees.
We just cut all the weeds down.
Well, we just want to know who is responsible for it. We don't want a child to get hurt. And that's in your district, I think, the first. So you should find out, is that city owned or is that private owned? And what can we do about it? Because too many children play around there, and you have all these homeless people and people live around there, and these child molesters in our community, and that's a perfect place to grab a kid. And we just want it cleaned up, and we would like to have it fixed up and cleaned up. That's all we're asking. How can we get that cleaned up? That's all we're asking. So we just like to know, who do we talk to? Is it city owned or is it public? Because
we'd have to find out.
I can make a comment on it now, but he's still under his minute, so I don't want to take from your time, Amari, but I can go ahead and answer.
Yeah, I got 48 seconds. Come on, we can kick it. But hey, the only thing we just want to know is, what can we do about it? Because people in the community have been asking me about it, and the officer at the Department of Motor Vehicles keep asking me about it, and I told him I would speak at it on the city council meeting tonight. Okay. Because something needs to be done about it.
I want to respect your time. Are you allowing
me? Well, I'm finished. 20? I ain't got nothing else to say.
So really quickly, it's the section that you're talking about, the Mid-Broadway lot. I've never heard it called a park. It's just always been the Mid-Broadway lot. That's the first lot. The second lot that's fenced in, it has a house in the front of it. Then it's got all of those things growing up.
Where the 15 trees are.
That's a private, right. That's a private residence. And then the back lot that's half paved, and then there's a lot of weeds growing into it. That is a city-owned lot. I believe back in I see Jan in back. We cleaned that up back in, I want to say 2009, 2010, something like that, under Mo Betta, Mothers and Others for a Better Newburgh. So we had cleaned up that lot. One of the things that we can go ahead and do is create another community cleanup and go ahead and tackle that. But just know that it's the Mid-Broadway lot that's currently under contract for potential development in that area. Then there's a privately held property with the burned up, boarded up house. And then there's the other lot, which is city owned. So that we did clean back in 2010. We removed, and it was a volunteer effort. You know, we got permission from the city to go ahead and do it, and we can go ahead and do it again. And that's what I know from those lots. If there's other lots that you're referring to, I don't have an update on that because I don't know. Am I correct that those are the three lots?
The community wants to know, that's all.
The lots behind the big empty house, DPW went over there last week and cut brush, and they were there for about 3 days cleaning that whole area. They've now set up the kids or whoever the neighborhood, I believe, set up basketball courts. So they've got that whole area cleaned out. Is that correct?
Yeah, but we have to remember that's not a proper place for our children to be playing in. I understand that that's what we currently have now. And we've had this conversation going back and forth about that. So if they're currently playing on it, we need to make sure that it's at least safe. Right, right. So we need to do those types of things. So I think it's part of an ongoing conversation and action plan that we need to have around creating safe parks for our children throughout the city. So, but you know, I'm always down for a community cleanup. So if we need to go ahead and do additional of that, I'm game.
Do I still got 20 seconds?
You gave it to me. And it
I just want to give a shout out. Everybody go to YouTube and check out my son's wedding last night at Anthony Pier 9. It was off the hook. Congratulations, my son Malcolm.
Hello, everyone. I'm actually here to give a big thanks to the city council members. I'm actually here to say thank you. We started, well, myself and a group of other of my friends and relatives started I didn't start the I'm So Newburgh Stop the Violence, but we participate in it, and we have events catered at keeping the kids off the street, because I don't know if you've noticed, our kids are getting shot every day, well, every other day. There's always a fight, there's always something going on in the city of Newburgh, and I just wanna thank you for your efforts. But I'm here to also ask that you guys kind of pump it up a little bit, because we have a lot of things planned and we're gonna need help to get it done. Okay, Now I have something to say about 104 South Lander. About a year and a half ago, I came here with a proposal and I gave it to Mayor Kennedy, myself and Charles Kimbrell, where we laid out a specific, detailed plan to help the children here. Apparently, something happened in between and it got tabled. Well, actually, it didn't get tabled. It was given to someone else. And then I told you about this person and I. We had a personal beef between us because if you're not for us, then you're against us. If you're not for the kids of Newburgh, then you're working against us. And it was brought to my attention that that building was being used for personal use, for her own personal use. She was even given grant money. She was even given grant money to further things for the student, for the kids there, and nothing came of it.
Her contract is up, by the way.
It should have never had. She never should have had it to begin with.
Yeah, but it is up. I want you to know that.
In light of that, we still want to go ahead with what we were proposed, and I want to be able to give that to you so you guys can read it because it'll work. The proposal Charles Kimbrell and I had, it'll work if you let us work it. We're here to make sure that our kids survive. I still have children living here. I want to see them thrive in the city of Newburgh, and it can happen. But when we come to you and we're telling you, we're doing it in sincerity. We're not here to get anything from you. We're trying to work together to make a cohesive plan to make Newburgh work. I think that if you have a personal problem with someone, if you have a personal problem with me, I'm woman enough to sit down at the table and discuss it. I don't have a problem doing that. But if you have a personal problem with me and you let that stand in the way of what these kids need, then that's pretty sad.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Jan Merkerson. Tammy Pebbles Hollins. Don't start my 3 minutes yet. Okay. First thing I want to do is I want to thank a couple of people as well as a couple of, I don't know if they're businesses, but I know they are organizations. So I want to thank Sheer Precision. It's a barbershop. I want to thank All Stars. It's a barbershop. And Agnostic Cuts, because for the last 2 weeks, they gave the children, the boys here in our community, free haircuts for school, and there was hundreds and hundreds of kids that came. They also fed those kids, and I also want to thank Stop the Violence and I'm So Newburgh, because that was something that they collaborated. Thank you, I think Cindy Holmes, they said Cedric Brown did something to get some permits to even get that started, and it kind of like have become a domino effect, so thank you. I also want to thank the Activity Center, because little do you know, the Activity Center gave us the majority of the activities that the kids played with or used. So I want to thank Derek, the Activity Center. Nobody knew that. I want to thank Maple, and he know who I'm talking about, but that's the city manager, because he approved all these things, and he was part of that also. So thank you. Last but not least, I want to just say, you know, we're talking about cleanup here in the city of Newburgh, and cleanup is good, but I want to just admonish the city manager and the Rock, and that's Jason, because I always tell Jason, you rock. And I want them to not just clean up the city, but clean out the city. Get all the mismanagement, misappropriation, and the theft out of this city, and let's build a good city. And so to those who's working hard and those who's hardly working, the ones who are working hard, we're going to make an impact. The ones who's hardly working, we're going to leave your behinds behind.
Peace. My name is Self Nas Born Allah. I represent, I'm a member of the Nation of Gods and Earths in Hudson Valley. I'd like to add on to her list, because you have a lot of people in the community that's actually doing things for the babies and adults as well. And one of those organizations is my organization, our organization, which is a law's best part. And we have Children's Days, Family Days, Universal Parliaments out in Liberty Park. And you know, for the babies, you know, where we have hundreds of children coming out to eat with games and stuff as well that we put together. And, you know, our events is very successful, and we get a lot of, praise for the things that we do out there, you know. And also, you know, I just think it's time for us to be responsible and start cleaning up our neighborhoods and start doing things that we, you know, that we like to do for our children. We got a lot of these organizations out here. I think the city council members need to get with these organizations and set a plan and put a goal into motion. You know, you got people in the community that's very responsible. You have people in the community who's not so responsible. So I just say, get with those people who's responsible and start adding on so we could do some things in the community. Seriously. Peace.
Sheila Murphy, the city of Newburgh. I just want to thank each and every one, the city council meeting, for coming out for Stop the Violence. And I just appreciate the how everybody just, you know, Amari, James, and everybody just came together as one, just helping the community for the kids. You know, we didn't have much, but what much we did have, it did make a difference. And that's what it's all about, just working together, putting all the negativity stuff aside and just come together and just do what we have to do. Even with, you know, we talk about the mayor building. You know, get some kids to help her fix up her buildings and, you know, train them how to work on carpenters and stuff like that. You know, we don't have nothing for the kids to do. Get a couple of kids, 10, 15, trade them how to put down carpet, windows, and stuff like that. Even our sidewalks, you know, our sidewalks are terrible. And I feel sorry for the people who don't have cars because, let me tell you something, when I walk down the streets, and if you don't watch where you're going, you would just bust your head wide open. Mm-hmm. So the money we get for CDBG, really, we really need to work on our sidewalks and our roads. And let's just, you know, every city has come together. In Newburgh, we can have a lot of money come in Newburgh, and let's just do what we're supposed to do.
Good evening, everyone. Dr. Benilda Jones, as a follow-up, City Council, is there a way to get some communication out to the business owners where the bridge is being restored so that they know that they're not forgotten? Because just the worry, as a business owner, I know you'll lose it. Mm-hmm. So maybe if they know that they're not forgotten, that you have a plan of action or something, that would also help to facilitate them from losing their minds as they are, you know, worrying about how they're going to make ends meet. Thank you.
Okay, if there's no more, go ahead.
Thanks, Mayor. Mike Ferrara, Police Chief. I just want to take the time to announce the fact that we are in the hiring process for the City of Newburgh Police Department. Applications are out now and they're available until the end of September. The test is going to be given in November, but now is the time to put the fill out your application and get that into City Hall. If you have any questions concerning it, this poster is going to be outside the door of City Hall, and there's quite a few posters around the city. If you're between the ages of 20 and 35 years old, you're eligible to take the police test, and starting pay is around $40,000, and it goes up from there. It's a great job. It's a great challenge. I've been doing this for quite a few years, as most of you know. But anyway, I just wanted to mention that. And also, the police department is going to have an open house on September 20th up at the Recreation Park on Washington Street. And we'll show some of the special units, the equipment that we have, and the different units that you can also get involved in other than patrol. Okay? And so if you have any questions, now's the time to fill out those applications before September 30th. Thank you. And also, if I must add, that city residents do get preference on that test, and it's very important.
Thank you. Thank you. Okay, it's now time for comments from City Council. So, Councilwoman Abrams.
Just wanted to say real quick that we, just to reiterate, that we do care. As a council, we do care. As individuals, we do care about the businesses over at on Route 32, near where the bridge is closed. Councilwoman Holmes and I personally went to every one of them the days preceding the International Festival, which was a great success. And we even put up a sign at the International Festival listing their names and urging people to support them. Ms. Murchison, am I pronouncing it right anyway? Thank you. You'll be glad to know that we do have great plans for the use of 104 South Lander Street coming up. My heart is at peace knowing that Derek Stanton is here with the city the rec director, our new rec director, and that we will make that building, clean it out first step, top to bottom, and add great things inside. I mean, but we're talking pool tables and ping pong tables and computers and all kinds of great stuff is coming up at long last. We will fix that up, and I just agree with you. Please go out and vote tomorrow. Exercise your right as Americans to get out and vote. We have a wonderful Democratic primary coming up. And please just go out, and however you vote, just make sure that you exercise your right to vote. And I'll see you there at the polls. Thanks.
Okay. I wondered what might have happened to this little girl as she appears on the scene tonight. But I was looking through my minutes, my back minutes of my council agendas, and I found the two articles. What's one that? Judy and one Deborah.
What?
Dolores Hamer, city of Newburgh, said that she doesn't like when she goes to government official buildings and asks for information, and it seems like certain things that she's asking for takes longer to get than it should. The building inspector said if the landlords haven't corrected certain things in your apartment, then the city will step in and make the repairs and bill the landlord. How long until someone steps in until they decide that something is done? She said they wouldn't want to live in the condition that she is living in, and she's going to keep coming into the meetings and bringing it up until something gets done. In 30 days, she'll be evicted, and there will be someone else there who probably would help her or give her and her seven kids a place to live. What should she do? Where should she live? What about her and her kids? No one would want to live in the conditions that she's living in. So she doesn't think it's fair that she should have to. Nobody is trying to help her, and she has seven kids that she has to take care of and a job that she has to go to. She also has child care, and none with any of that. She's a single mother doing it by herself and doing what she has to do in order to get her benefits. Enough is enough. When is it going to stop, and when is someone going to help her? She's going on another month with no electricity on the second floor. And she mentions again she has the seven kids. When is this going to stop, and when is it going to get power? Enough is enough. And then this is March 24th, 2014. Then the other article here is Judy. Let's see. In regard to the living conditions mentioned by one of our residents earlier, she said that her son bought a house here with a partner a few years ago, and the partnership broke up. So he asked for her help. The lady who lives in this apartment is not paying her rent. Social services is paying for it. There were violations on the house when she got involved with it, and she had a contract to go in to see how things could be fixed or he could fix the violation. After going through the entire building and all the things that needed to be cleaned up, she was told that there were too many issues and that the building is not fit for someone to be living in. She wrote a letter on January 17th to the lady living there, telling her that it would be too dangerous to try to remove this building with seven children or to try to renovate it. She was concerned the children and their safety have that kind of renovation going on in the building. So she gave her 30 days. It wasn't an official notice, and it was a letter. She asked her to try to find another place and told her she would refund her deposit and help her make a deposit on another place. She has not been able to find another place to go in the meantime. In the meantime, all the electricity went out in the building. And then this kind of died off here. But I just happened to come across this today because I was really concerned about this girl, really, with those kids. I'm sorry? Oh, you're still here. Good for you. I thought I just saw you walk out. No, because when all this happened, you didn't come forth.
back and forth. I never talked to a landlord.
Okay. Thank you, but we have to. It's the council's time. All right, Regina is supporting you.
Afterwards,
we heard your concerns. Okay, but you got to let us address the problems now. Okay, it's not falling on deaf ears. Okay?
Okay, these are just trivial. Primary day tomorrow. And the polls will be open from 6 a.m. to 9 p.m.
Yeah!
Okay, so Ward 1, Board of Education and Horizons is where you could go to vote. I'm losing my voice. Ward 2 is South Junior High. Ward 3 and 4 would be the Activity Center from 6 to 9 p.m. So if Alan, well, it's going to be too late, Alan. It's tomorrow. There's just a couple little complaints. We had such an abundance of hot dog wagons along Broadway Lane. They're just creeping up. I just wanted to ask the city manager if he could check with the health department. Maybe they could see if they all have health certificates. Post it, because it's very important that they do.
Sure, we could check
that. No matter what they're selling out there. But there's somebody selling the... Somebody was telling me a big pan they have food in it. They were selling out of a big pan. You know, we can't have all this going on. Okay. And then when we were working on the parking ordinance, I didn't really support that parking ordinance. And they decided they were going to give tickets out after 4 o'clock. We close, City Hall closes at 4. And they're giving out tickets 4 to 6 after we close, and that's not fair. That's not fair. And on a Friday when we close down for 2 days, we shouldn't be not out penalizing people on a Saturday. The parking meters are there, but they should not have to be penalized. We have people coming in the shop on a Saturday. Thank God they're coming into Newburgh at all. And then we stick them with parking tickets. And it hurts the businesses, and it hurts the people that are shopping. So that's the thing we ought to look into, really. Amend it if we have to somehow. It looks like we're making our money on parking meters now, which is too bad that we have to fall back on it. Okay.
Councilman Brown.
Well, they're there for a reason. It's the merchants that wanted the parking meters because people kept taking the spots and never moving, and then nobody could come in the shop. So now they got the parking meters. Sometimes the merchants use them. We're going to reactivate our Citizens Advisory Committee, and we're in the process of getting members, and some old members and some new members, but we'd like to get that going because that helps the whole city. It really does. It doesn't matter we're on our own individual ward. It's still trying to get around the whole city to help out. And the incident on Lake Street, I think we should have a banner made saying, Mr. City Manager, saying our businesses are open with big letters. Put it right out there on those barrels there so people could go in and shop. One man has padlocks on his door now. So, I mean, it's getting desperate over there. And those people have left already, so... Well, that's about it. And I'm trying to get another person in my ward for the Police Community Action Committee. So I got one signed up.
Okay.
Judy, Cindy wants two, so all right.
Okay.
That's all I had to say. Thank you all for coming.
Councilman Brown.
Councilwoman Angela, I just want to tell you that one Saturday, my wife came home and said that she had gotten a parking ticket for not paying the meter. And she asked me, what was I supposed to do about it? And I told her to pay it. So it runs down the street. So it's a quarter to pay the meter, whether it's Monday through Sunday, whatever it is, put a quarter in the meter, and you don't get a parking ticket. So there's no sympathy on my part for that. I want to talk about the kids in the park over there on Liberty Street. Michael, if you can, get DPW to get over there and take a good look at that park and see what we can do to clean it up as soon as possible. And I don't think we have any money in the budget currently, but we are in the midst of doing a new budget coming up, so we will certainly put some money in the budget for rehabilitation of parks. So that way that doesn't happen and we'll keep it up so the kids are safe playing in those parks. I want to talk about 104 South Lander a minute. I know there's been a lot of adversity against Pastor Austin in that location, but I want this council to tread lightly with that. Despite what you have or how you feel about Pastor Austin, you have to remember she is servicing kids. And so are you dispersing Pastor Austin despite the kids? I don't have a problem with Pastor Austin having to leave that building, but there needs to be a plan put in place so the kids that are currently in her service are not displaced. And I won't allow this council to move in any other direction until there's something put in place to make sure those kids are going to be okay with some other services that they can partake in to replace Pastor Austin. So let's not make it about Pastor Austin and her missteps. Let's make it about the kids and get a good understanding of that. I just want to thank everybody for coming out. You guys have a good night. Thank you.
I just want to thank everybody for coming out. And everybody should know we do care about our children, and we will support as much as we can the events. And I thank everybody for being there that was at the events, Jan, you, sir, everybody that supported the kids. We did what we could. We did the bouncy house and got a lot of sponsors, and we'll do any type of events if we can, if we have the efforts to support that. And also, going back to the park, I do agree with what Councilman Brown said. You know, we don't have the funds with Dionne Park. That money was allocated for that, I believe, in 2012. So sometimes we have money. If we don't use it, we will lose it. And it has to be allocated for what it was allocated for. So that's why we're working on that. But I just want to thank each and every one of you for coming out. Have a good night.
Okay. I want to thank you for coming out. And I'm sure we'll have a private talk about the house and about this article in the newspaper. But you should also know if something is true, then it's not a politically motivated item. This has been going on since March. But that's not really what I want to tell you. I have been doing some research, and it's not the first time I've done research, but I want to share with you. You know, sometimes things happen in life and you move so fast and things go on so quickly that you forget what you really loved. When I was a kid, Shirley Chisholm was our congresswoman. And so I've been doing some research on her. She was the first black woman, she was the first black to seek the office of presidency, the first woman. And so I want to say that to you because this is, we can go very far if we let go and just go and keep moving and keep going. We show that to our children. We show that to our young people. I consider the two of you, and actually quite a few of you in the room, to be young. You're younger than me. I've been 29 almost a couple of times already. So let me just tell you a little bit about Shirley Chisholm and why I'm so proud to have known her. She was an assemblywoman who served 4 years. But we have unemployment benefits have been extended to domestic workers because of her. What I'm saying to you is not so much that I love Shirley Chisholm, I do, but that there's places for you to go. And if we keep getting hung up on the small things, we'll never get there, and your children won't get there because they won't know how to move forward and move past the small things. Something has happened, it wasn't good. I would like to see you move on with your children. And remember women like Shirley Chisholm and Susan B. Anthony and Maya Angelou, who said, you might be defeated. You may experience defeat, but you don't have to be defeated. And of course, my mentor Shirley Chisholm, unbought and unbossed. Keep moving. Don't stop. Don't come. There's very little we can do. But when you come here, this is where we conduct business. And sadly, sometimes private and personal business gets mixed in here. But this is a hopefully an opportunity for me to say to you, we have two colleges. I'd like to see our young people in one of them and moving ahead. I'm pretty sure at this stage in my life that I have more years in back of me than I do in front of me, and I'd like to at some point pass the torch. So please get yourself a good education so there'll be somebody to pass it to. Thank you, and good night.
Councilwoman Mejia.
Yeah, I want to thank everyone for coming out, and just really quickly say that, you know, before coming to this meeting, I left a very dear friend of mine. Thanks for indulging. On her deathbed at the hospital. So if I'm a bit somber, it's because of that. Okay, I gotta find my core. And as I listened to the colorful comments, you know, I pondered, how can we help the babies and how can we build our community? So we can do that by supporting one another through constructive criticism. And I would love to hear that constructive criticism coming from all of you, from residents, from business owners, when you get up, not just around the 3-minute time frame that we have, but every day. So how can we help the babies and build our community? Let's all do our part. Take a risk, lend your wisdom to someone who's younger than you and show them the way through example. Everybody knows that actions speak louder than rhetoric. So that's what we gotta do every day. And so when we give our colorful criticism, know that the kids, know that the adults, know that the seniors hear it in our voice, whether they see it visually or through the camera or through print. So think about that when you do your constructive criticism. So how can we help the babies and build our community? I agree that with Councilman Brown, that we are in budget season, and regardless of whether we like it or not, the budget of a community reflects its priorities. So as we start this next budget season, my priorities, and I think all of the, and I would hope that the rest of our priorities, the budget starts to reflect that. So what does that mean for me? It means safety and clean streets. And so I will fight to make sure that our budget represents that accordingly. And around the safety, I have to include also there our environmental safety, because how can we build and help our babies and build our community if we don't have a safe municipality? So thank you for indulging me in my emotional sharing of you guys, because life is so precious, guys. Life is just so precious. When I walk out of here, I'm gonna go pick up my daughter, and then I'm gonna make a call at the hospital and see how she's doing. And so, Darlene, this city's gonna be a safe city. This city's gonna be a clean city.
Damn right. Straight on.
Because we need it. And I hate being emotional. So, thank you, guys.
We love you, Councilwoman Mejia.
Love you back.
One of the things that's great is we're being real and authentic, and you're being real and authentic, and we appreciate that. That's our humanity that shows that everybody so has that. And my heart goes to you and to your friend. And I agree with Councilwoman and Councilman Brown and Mejia that you know, our youth is our tomorrow, and we have to work with that, and we have to set examples for them. And for those who stood to the mic and said, we're ready to work together, we want to do something to work together to move this city forward, I applaud you, because that is the only way we are going to get anywhere. We have to work together. And I really applaud Mr. Alvarez, Joe Alvarez, and his work in putting together the I'm So Newburgh at the Park. Councilman Brown, I believe you helped him with that. I know we did. And I know the city manager worked with him, and Councilwoman Holmes, and all the rest. There are people coming to various ones of us, and they want to do something. They want to do something. It's not just one, but many that are coming with ideas and suggestions and so forth. And so, really, it's a wonderful thing. My heart goes out to the business people that are struggling. We are so, wait till people leave here. This is a council that is 100% behind our business people. We have been trying to do everything we can to help support the businesses, grow the businesses, encourage more businesses to come here, and keep them going. And what I know for sure, it's 9 times easier to keep a business than to get a new one. So we really have to work with the ones that we have and encourage them. And so I want to do everything we can. And I really like somebody's suggestion is talk to the National Guard about a temporary bridge. It hadn't occurred to me. But if we could do that, that would be a great idea. And I would also like to just say thank you to all of the folks and all of the barbershops that have been offering free haircuts. What a great thing. What a great idea. And a way to reach young people and reach families. I want to say thank you to Derek Standring. I'm Standring, that's somebody else. Stanton. Derek Standring lives in Colorado. Another person. But to our Parks and Rec director, who is really working hard to put together programs for our youth. And we'll continue working with him on that. Thank you very much. And what was the other thing? The communication to the businesses on Leek Street. I think I know somebody who could get their email addresses or their mail addresses, and we could then keep them updated on the progress. Because I thought that was a good idea. I thought that was a good idea to try and reach them. And this whole house situation, I just want everybody to know. I'm not going to go into the big details. The paper covered it quite well. I have known about the violations. I have been trying to get them fixed since January. There was no way to do that until somebody moved out, and that didn't happen until August. I'm in there working on them now, and I've got people working with me to get it done. That building will meet all codes, and we'll move forward. So just want you to know that's what I'm committed to doing now that I can get in the building and make it happen. And I don't think there's anything else. There's a lot of things we're working on. I encourage everybody to get to the police open house, see what they have. Make sure that you check that out. If you're interested in becoming a police officer, make sure you apply to go to the test. And that's it. Have a good night. Dismissed.